This here is what I like to call the perfect monitor for the new MacBooks. Not only it is able to easily connect with your M1 device, but if you have a Windows PC on the side, you can quickly switch to it as well. This here is an ultra-fine display Ergo 4K monitor with HDR10, and even though it comes with its own monitor stand, I decided to go with a pneumatic spring stand that can easily adjust to the weight of the monitor so it looks suspended. So thank you Vivo for sponsoring today's video. Unboxing this monitor was totally different from my 38-inch new ultra-wide screen. In fact, the box needed to be flat on a table so we could properly reveal the contents inside of it without damaging anything. The first thing you will find on the right is the power brick with a DC input, unlike most monitors, which have a EIC C13 plug. And I would say this is long enough to properly cable manage it and route it through my Vivo monitor stand. Also, LG included 3 cables where you will find an HDMI, a USB-C, and an extension cable for the power brick in case it doesn't make it to the monitor. We got some manuals that came along with a disc, but most importantly, LG have included an Ergo stand not sold separately that came with a base plate in case you want to drill through the table. Definitely very different from their ultra-wide alternative that simply came with a desk stand. Right from the get-go, the monitor arm is already all set up. And it feels very sturdy, delivers an incredible amount of fluid movement, and fits desks of around 0.85 inches minimum. This is such a great stand with great cable management and is super easy to set up. You can easily rotate it to fit landscape mode in case you're coding, or simply have it horizontal to consume most type of content, although the arm does wobble quite a bit for my liking. The only thing I would say is that I just find it hard to position it straight at times. Now, the cable management this delivers is absolutely awesome. On top of the arm, all you need to do is pop the cover off, slide the slider piece off, and feed your cables, where you can then close everything up to remove cables out of your sight. Reminds me exactly of the universal arm Vivo have just recently sent. Although, Vivo makes it easier when handling a lot of thicker cables because the compartment on this arm is really tight. I hate seeing cables within my setups, and the fact that both of these arms can hide pretty much anything is so satisfying. But I personally need a bit more freedom in terms of VESA adapters to fit any monitor I want, make sure my cables stretch enough within my tubes, and a softer pad to avoid ruining this desk. Which is why for you and I, the Ergo arm can be a no-go. Look, Vivo has been a company I've personally been buying stands from, and they were kind enough to send this one in. So I thought it would be awesome to replace the Ergo arm with their pneumatic arm single monitor desk mount, mainly due to the fact that the Ergo arm doesn't have universal support. Putting it all together and setting it all up was super easy to do, and I love the fact this comes with a proper soft pad to protect this desk. Luckily, this thing does have great cable management within its tubes. A lot of arms don't seem to integrate this type of feature where they build hollow tubes within their sets. Just makes cables super easy to route and completely hide them. The mount is made out of a sturdy aluminum where the end delivers the connectivity for the VESA mount plate. And it's super awesome that the bracket is super easy to mount, unlike most monitor arms. The arm itself has great freedom of movement where I can easily adapt it any way I want and even rotate the screen horizontally and vertically. It delivers a wide variety of angles where you can pull the monitor to allow the cables to properly stretch, due to the way the transparent cover was made. Plus, it just overall looks super awesome within the desk. Although, like I said, I needed something a bit more versatile just in case we drift away from this monitor and bring something else. Definitely enjoy the adjustability it offers with the gas springs, so I'm sure any monitors below 34 inches will be held with ease. Vivo has been a brand I've personally been buying for our setups, and I can't thank them enough to have sponsored today's video. But look, overall, this monitor is not going on my setup because I wanted to have an HDR10 panel for the MacBook. Now, the back of this is of course not RGB, but we did decide to put some Philips Hue bars on it. It just makes the overall aesthetics of it look so much nicer. It is a monitor that delivers a USB-C connection with a couple of HDMI ports, a display port, and some USB-A connections. In case you don't have a hub like the call digit, you can always use the monitor as a centralized unit to connect things such as your SSD and even wireless peripherals. But in all honesty, it is a monitor that can feel super sturdy, has really nice thin bezels, and delivers a great picture quality. With a 4K UHD resolution, an aspect ratio of 16:9, and 350 nits of brightness, this IPS panel delivers great picture quality with its 95% DCI-P3 color gamut. It does have an anti-glare coat on it, which makes it extremely nice when viewing the screen at different angles, and with a contrast ratio of 1000:1, it makes this $750 monitor a great contestant for our MacBook Pro display needs. Just keep in mind, you always want your contrast ratio to be between 1000:1 and 3000:1. Anything above that will most likely be a marketing hook. But at this ratio, watching movies, editing our content, and playing games has been great, especially in a dark room. Although, let's not get carried away here, this isn't really a gaming monitor, especially with a 5 millisecond response rate and a 60Hz refresh rate. It does have a game mode and AMD FreeSync, which of course is G-Sync compatible. So if you want to use your Windows PC with an RTX on it to game, well, don't worry, Nvidia supports FreeSync as of 2018, so no need to worry about screen tearing. And with a flat panel like so, the viewing angles of 178 degrees do seem like they extend quite some more. Also, 350 nits is quite dim for a panel, mainly if you're constantly looking at a screen with 1000 nits of brightness. It is something to be taken into account, so this is why I tend to set its brightness at 100%. So please be aware of the big difference in terms of nits. Look, for a 31.5 inch 2160 panel, things are super sharp and the colors look awesome. The form factor does allow you to be able to easily multitask within apps and delivers a good amount of room to be able to edit within a Premiere Pro timeline. Even splitting the screen in half with Premiere Pro on one side can still deliver a productive workflow. For comparison, here is the same workflow on the 38 inch from LG. I would say it's not too bad at all considering the other monitor is $1000 more. For us, it was super important to be able to have an HDR10 panel in order to properly color grade images, so when it comes to uploading them online, the colors wouldn't be off. Just as an example, here's the color difference between my iPhone 13 Pro Max display and the LG monitor display. Note that it's super important you have the right picture mode within the menu to match it as much as you can. To change any type of settings for the screen, like with most LG monitors, you do have this little joystick underneath that also acts as a power button. Here, you can either choose to power off, change your input device, take a look at your settings, and quickly change the picture mode. This does have a few awesome picture modes that allows you to adapt to the content you are consuming. Whether it's cinema mode, HDR mode, or even vivid mode, it's super awesome having this much flexibility within this 4K panel. Now, the settings menu does have this PlayStation 5 feel to it. Within, you can change the quick settings, choose your input, picture mode, sound, and some overall general settings, which does bring me to the speaker test. For a couple of 5W speakers, they don't sound bad at all. Although at this point, I just recommend you let your MacBook Pro deliver the sound. And it's super awesome being able to swiftly change between something like your custom PC and your MacBook Pro. All thanks to both HDMI ports in the back, of course. For such a monitor, the wattage consumption is honestly not that bad at all. I did connect this little guy to the wall and I saw about 51 watts when in use and about 13 watts when in power saving mode. So in terms of electricity, it really isn't such a big deal, which could explain why it doesn't compete with my 96W USB-C power adapter. Although, if you have the base model of the 14 inch with its 67W power brick, chances are, the MacBook will charge a bit quicker. Just know that the more you push the laptop, the slower it will charge. For things such as video editing and running Xcode simulators, you might not be able to charge it at the same rate you are losing power, so it wouldn't be a bad thing to keep using MagSafe. Keep in mind that this is by no means an XDR display replacement. For an ultra-fine monitor at such price, I think it is such a bang for your buck, mainly due to the color accuracy, HDR, and 4K panel this has. Not only that, it is super easy to set up and already out of the box, it delivers a great stand. I was expecting this to be well above $1000. In my opinion, this is a very good monitor to recommend. Just know that this is nothing like a Retina display, but even at the price they go for, I don't even feel like spending the money for one is worth it, which is why we got this color accurate beast for our editing setup. I hope this video gives you an idea of what type of monitor you can get for your new MacBook Pro. It is definitely worth checking out, and make sure you always buy your tech with a 30-day return policy. If not satisfied, you can always return the products we recommend and review on this channel. I hope you guys have enjoyed this review. Next month, we got a few setups I would love to showcase, as well as the new office we are currently still building. Next video, I will be revealing why the M1 13-inch might be the best laptop for you. So stay tuned and take care.